They say it's good to have friends in high places. Well, if you track and trace the behavior and actions of the wealthiest of the wealthy individuals, corporations, and institutions, they seem to know ahead of time when events will take place. Today is no different. There are many indicators to watch for, many places to look. Not all are clear and concise, but one thing is absolute. The general public is always last to the party. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Today we are going to talk about the super rich. What exactly are they preparing for right now? We always get these signals coming through and we don't know who to believe, what direction to go. But some things are made public. We may not get names, we may not get numbers, but we can certainly see the trends. And I'm going to show you a lot of that today. I'm going to give you some detail and I want to break it down for you step by step. The first thing I wanted to cover is the Federal Reserve. And why? Because the actions of the central banks are the number one primary factor for what happens with asset prices. You can see the Fed balance sheet and the S&P 500 mirrored on top of each other from 2008 up until the present, and it is very clear what has happened. You could see that they instituted QE1, and that was beneficial to the markets. The markets saw this as the Federal Reserve, the central banks around the world, helping them out and being there as the lender of last resort. They said QE1 would be the only thing they would ever need because the market is strong, it just needs a little boost. But of course, we had QE2, and we had Operation Twist, and QE3. All of these, in general, led the market to new highs. And then we got to 2015, 2016, and there has been some major changes ever since then. If you paid attention to this time frame, you would know that something definitely broke. You saw all of this different statistics, manufacturing, and shipping, freight, everything was down, down, down. And you actually saw the stock market going sideways for this period of time. And it wasn't until central banks around the world decided to give it another boost before they came back up. And we saw the S&P 500 take another ride up. Now with the introduction of QE4, we are moving into uncharted territory because this is different than all of those previous instances. In those previous ones, they were telling us that it just needs another boost here. We are on our way to recovery. However, from 2017 and onward, we were told everything has never been better. So why then are they printing $60 billion per month along with all the repo operations and everything else they're doing behind the scenes if everything is just fine? Seems rather unusual, doesn't it? Well, the Federal Reserve and central banks are really responsible for the divide that is created in between the haves and the have-nots. This needs to be understood. According to Janet Yellen, though, when she was the Fed chair, she denied the actions of the Fed and their impact on the market. Fed Chair Janet Yellen rejected the notion that the Fed has a third pillar of policy to keep the stock market prices afloat. We do know, in fact, that this is what they do. It's crazy that they actually had to say this at some point. She said, and I quote, "We do not target a level of stock prices that is not an appropriate thing to do." But this is exactly what they have done. As soon as they started to wean off their quantitative easing with their quantitative tightening policy, and we saw this coming down slowly but surely down to a level that was still excessively high, something around the range of $3.7 trillion, the market freaked out. It really freaked out, and things took a turn for the worse. We saw how bad it became in such a short period of time. They had to reverse that trend, and they are now at about $4.1 trillion and change. We're going to see how long it takes them to surpass what they had before and still somehow claim that everything is fine. This is just the most unusual situation historically that I have ever heard about. Back in 2010, we had Ben Bernanke defending QE talks wealth effect in op-ed. I just wanted to point out here that back then they printed $600 billion, and this was huge at the time. Everybody was suggesting, this is crazy. I can't believe they're doing this. Why are they going to this level? Does this really need to happen? The central bank has never needed to go this far, but it's only temporary. It's an emergency. We're going to do this now, and we'll be back up and running in no time. Looks like that didn't occur, because here we are, QE4, and they are still unwilling to admit the damage they have done. So what have the super rich been doing? Well, as you can see this article here, the world's super rich are hoarding physical gold in secret bunkers. You can read the details if you're interested. I simply wanted to note the fact that there are prominent individuals who have been buying a lot of gold, a lot of farmland, a lot of different assets that are real. They've been doing this as stocks have been rising. And certainly you can see how much money has been moving into gold. Global gold back exchange traded funds, ETFs, and similar products had $19 billion or 400 pounds of net inflows in 2019 after holdings rebounded in December. ETF holdings reached an all-time high of 2,900 tons. It is a large sum. There's no way to deny that. A lot of people put their money in this way because they feel more comfortable than buying actual gold. That's a whole different topic. But it just shows you that there is demand there for a safe haven, even as we are seeing the maximum euphoria. Some people are taking one path and others are going down a different road. This chart here is showing you the quarterly official gold reserves, China, India, Mexico, Russia, and Turkey. Clearly, China and Russia have been purchasing an extremely large amount of gold over the last several years. They've been diversifying away from the US dollar, potentially because they have to, but no doubt they've been going down this road. They've been weaning off of their US debt slowly but surely in the case of China, more quickly in the case of Russia, and they've been buying up gold. You could see the other central banks are doing the same thing. These are large sums coming from central banks that could simply print money if they wanted to. But certainly they know the result of that. Take a look at the gold price right now as I record this video, $1,562. I think it peaked out around $1,613, which is extremely high from what we've seen. But just looking at it here in the last little while, it has done very well because of the tensions. Yet, if you look at the VIX index, it is super low. You see what the stock market is doing, barely flinched during all these activities that have been happening recently. And certainly this could escalate if we see more geopolitical tension and problems underlying everything that have been hidden for so long. Survival of the richest. Luxurious doomsday-proof bunkers are becoming more alluring to the ultra-wealthy as they fight to get their hands on the $4.5 million post-apocalyptic homes fitted with swimming pools, ranges, and dog parks. You could see them for yourself here. I just wanted to use this as an example. I've seen many articles like this. Essentially, we are looking at all of these different bunkers that are being built for people and not some hole in the ground. These are designed for people with a lot of money. They're getting sold out. That's what tells you. It's not just one individual that had this idea to build some of these. They are actually selling out. So what do these people know? That they're buying gold, they're buying land, they're buying bunkers. What do they know that we don't? Well, I could tell you something. With all of the central bank intervention, with all of their activities devaluing the currency, we have seen asset prices rising to levels they have never been at before. And some would say that's fantastic. But if you look at the housing affordability index, it's going to give you a different picture. I really like this resource, Atom Data Solutions. Atom is spelled A-T-T-O-M. If you do a search online, you'll find this. They have their home affordability report, and I've shown you data from this before many times, in fact. Median home prices remain unaffordable for average US wage earners. Okay, sounds about right. But did you know that 71% of the cases, that is true. 71% of the time, housing is unaffordable for the average US wage earner. That is incredible. incredible. Think about that for a second. They have created this plan to print money out of thin air, and that inflates the money supply. That's what inflation is. The result of which is an increase in the price that you pay for different things. Maybe that's Apple stock or Amazon stock. Maybe that's your house. Maybe that's your food. Maybe that's your electricity. It doesn't necessarily directly funnel into where you think it's going to be. We've seen commodities being boosted up in certain cases. We've seen housing do that. We have looked at equities and bonds and whatever all throughout time as central banks pump money into the system. So this right here just shows you, for the average person, they can't afford their home. Most people think that this is not a problem. Look, hey, what's wrong with it? You make this much money, you pay that much in your bills, everything is just fine. But when you pay such an enormous amount of your income towards your rent or towards your real estate prices or towards your real estate costs, mortgages and so on, that doesn't leave you with enough money to go out there and stimulate the economy. You're not going to go to restaurants as often. You're not going to go to the movie theater. You're not going to spend money on renovating your home and so on. All of this helps the economy, but if you spent all that money just simply buying your home, you're going to have to hunker down and you're going to need to save for a little bit, pay down that debt. This is all the short-term thinking. And of course, every time there's a bubble, we encounter the exact same thing. Go Banking Rates had this survey. Of course, with any survey, you're getting a limited view of what's going on. But as I've shown you before, 1,000 people here, 10,000 people there, it starts to add up. And of course, the bigger picture is revealed. Almost half of respondents, 45%, say they have $0 in a savings account. Another 24% said that they have less than $1,000 in savings. Is that because they've been investing in Amazon? Did they get that 0.7 shares? Well, apparently the top reason respondents said they weren't saving more was because they were living paycheck to paycheck. Do you personally know anybody that lives paycheck to paycheck? Many times, this is because of their own situation. They spend all their money. They don't know how to save. Unfortunately, though, for many, they're working 2 and 3 jobs. They can't make ends meet. That's the growing number of people that I'm concerned about. Not the people that don't know how to deal with their money and they spend it all on the newest, the latest, and greatest iPhone, keeping up with the Kardashians. I get that. It's those people working at 2 and 3 jobs that simply can't make this work. That's a problem, and it's really the result of what central banks are doing. There's more in here if you want to check it out. I always like reading these stats because it gives me some good insight as to what people are dealing with. That was the newest Go Banking Rates survey, I believe. So definitely check it out. Link will be in the description. Then I'm going to show you a series of articles, just quickly skipping through them, all basically sharing the same data. Goodbye, Big Apple. More people are leaving New York than any other state in the U.S. New York, California, high tax state exodus just beginning, according to these so-called experts. Then you look at this one. Wealthy Americans flee high tax states, take billions with them, tax the rich leave. That's a quote. Then you look at this. Illinois lost more population in 2019 than any other state except New York. This chart here from WirePoints. If you want to know a good resource for this type of data, definitely check out wirepoints.org. They've got so many different charts, constantly updating on a regular basis. As Illinois loses a record number of people to other states, its tax base is taking a big hit too. Of course, if people are leaving, you don't have enough individuals to be pumping up that Ponzi scheme you got going. This is a big pain in the you-know-what. These governments need more and more and more taxation. If you look at it on a national level, there is more taxes this year than there were the year before, than there were the year before, than there were the year before. Every single year, the government gets more money through taxation, and yet it somehow can't keep up with it all because the deficit increases and the debt increases. There are major shifts that are happening right now with people moving from one part of the country to the other. They're moving out of the United States entirely. They're buying up gold. They're buying up land. They're getting into things they never did before. Changes are happening on all levels of the spectrum. You're seeing this with the richest of the rich. You're seeing it people at the very bottom. I saw Taco Bell apparently is going to hire some managers at $100,000 a year. I mean, everything is mixed up right now. But eventually, everything always reverts to the mean. We've seen that so many times before. Every cycle, it appears, it reemerges, and ultimately, we need to be paying attention. We need to be paying close attention to what's occurring in order to be on the ball. That's all for this video. If you found it informative, hit that like button. Stop right there. Don't go anywhere. Click that one button. I appreciate it very much. If you want to learn about e-commerce, I created a free e-course, step-by-step, teaching you how to sell on Amazon, and you pay $0. That's right, $0. It is not some sort of scam. There's nothing there. I want to teach you how to actually make income on your own. Check it out at theamazongps.com. If you want to understand the financial system, literally from the top to the bottom, I created these two books that are so super simple for everybody, whether you have experience or not. Check these two out. You'll be able to understand so much. Link in description. If you want the audiobook, themoneygps.com. Wait a second, don't go anywhere. This is the one for you. 40-second video is gonna help you out a lot. Teaches you exactly what's gonna happen in the stock market. 40-second video. I'll see you there.